r/askreddit by Reddit and chill. What are some lesser known secondary uses for an everyday product? Use salt as an abrasive and absorber when cleaning. I spray my stovetop with a general household cleaner, then sprinkle salt liberally over the top. It gets grease out easily. For liquid stains like wine, I pour salt over the stain to soak up excess liquid, then come through with hydrogen peroxide. Finally, I get absorbent towels and dab clean it. Bleach to keep away cockroaches. I used to get big ass cockroaches in the summer that came up my drain. My exterminator told me to pour 1 cup of bleach down my drain each week. You have to pour it down the drain in the room you see them. I started 18 months ago and haven't seen a cockroach since. Can you hear their little screams through the plumbing now? Clear nail polish. Prevent skin going green from brass. Permanently stop fabric from fraying. Same goes with yarn. Seal paint. The $2 quick dry stuff is the best for me. I've used it to cover metal buttons that I was allergic to, and also to stop runs in my pantyhose. Add salt to your hand wash to get gasoline smell off. Love, Dad. I've always done salt and vinegar to get the gas smell off. But if you're working on a car, salt and vinegar will remind you of every ducking cut on your hands. Shaving foam reduces stops misting on bathroom mirrors and car windows. You can also use it to write creepy text like "I died here" or "I'm watching you" on mirrors of other people's bathrooms. When done right, it will be pretty much invisible normally, but the text will show up when someone is taking a bath shower and the mirror fogs up. Any cooking oil is a great way to remove the residue from stickers. IDK if this is recommended, but if you get scratches on wood furniture, I've always taken a matching washable marker, colored over the scratch, and then wiped it with a damp cloth to effectively stain the wood back to match. Rub a walnut nut on wood scratches. Also, just go buy a small bottle of Goo Gone. It is that oil, but smells great and does a better job than cooking oil. It's like a buck for a couple ounces, and that bottle has lasted me years. Edit. Used walnut nut to differentiate it from using a whole walnut, so someone isn't rubbing a dry walnut shell on their wood. Edit 2. Heavy nut meat. Toilet seat covers are the same as blotting paper for oily skin. This is my favorite one so far. Those papers are expensive. If you have a French press for coffee, you can also froth milk in it after. Pour in hot milk and raise and lower the plunger until the volume of the milk has about doubled. Not my channel, but plugging for James Hoffman. If you like coffee and want to explore the utter depths of the world of coffee, coffee gear, coffee science in a super chill and informative way, check him out. Keep going for free butter. Any kind of cooking oil will easily get pine sap off of your hands. Just use it like soap. Would this work for windshields? Clean mascara wands are used in animal shelters to soothe the animals by brushing, and to remove fly eggs and larvae from fur. Can I actually send them my old mascara wands? Vagisil for chafing. It's antibacterial, lubricating, and an anesthetic. I learned that in the army, and sponsor a NASCAR team. Use vet wrap instead of sports tape. It's basically the same thing but much less expensive. Great stuff. And baling twine can be used to fix anything. If you can't use twine to fix it, it ain't worth fixing. Okay. Maybe not, but twine is great too. Edit. Corrected baling to baling. Today I learned how to spell. Also, thank you for the silver. Put a somewhat thick layer of Vaseline on the skin around your hairline and ears and neck when dyeing your hair. If you accidentally get dye on your skin, you can easily wipe it off. I used to do that. One day I could not find the Vaseline. I used olive oil instead. It worked great. Cornstarch is a good blood coagulant if you need to stop bleeding. I saved my pet tarantula with cornstarch like this before. Her abdomen split after falling on tile, and the cornstarch stopped her from bleeding out. Several months later and she's doing great after that almost fatal fall. If you have a highlighter that's dying, take the pen part of it out of the casing and soak it in nail polish remover. It will revitalize it to working like new. This would have made coloring time so much more fun in kindergarten. especially since like only two markers would work by November. Liquid laundry detergent glows under black lights but is clear under normal light. You can dip a tip in some detergent and draw right on your walls and only see it with a black light on. Different brands glow different colors. Lots of fun in dorm rooms. If you're in a dorm room, that's probably not detergent. WD-40 removes old adhesives from anything without damage or staining or discoloration. A smaller can of WD-40 can be used on a normal sized can of WD-40 when its lid is stuck. Blue Dawn dish soap works really well on clothing stains, especially grease and oil stains. Also, many stains are set by drying, not grease and oil stains. Dawn dish soap is the best stain remover ever. Makeup remover wipes are really good at getting bike chain grease off your hands. Also, mixing some sugar with some fairy liquid. The sugar acts as an effective abrasive. Edit. Fairy liquid is a cleaning product in the UK. Or at least in Scotland, but I think UK-wide. Coffee grounds are quite versatile. Among other things, you can use them for a soil additive to improve the pH balance for plants. Place them in a refrigerator to neutralize odors. Scour pots and pans. De-icing your steps and driveway. An ant repellent. An exfoliating scrub for your skin. Ground coffee powder is amazing at neutralizing vomit smell on carpets or fabrics. I was once in an international flight that would last 9 hours. And on hour 3 a child threw up on the aisle. The stewardess gracefully poured 2 handfuls of coffee powder on the leftover stain. After removing the puddle, and the smell instantly went away. Condensed milk for those with chronic vomiting. Not only is it great for cooking, but I had a pharmacist tell me about adding some water till it is the consistency of thick soup. Get the person to sip small amounts of it slowly. It helps line the esophagus to reduce vomiting, and allowing medication time to hit the stomach and work. Also provides much needed sugar. I've used it on kids and adults and it's worked a treat every time. Sweetened condensed milk? I didn't realize there was another kind until my brother screwed up his pumpkin pie, so now I know to ask. That's a really cool tip though. Wear conditioner as shaving cream. Edit. I am only buying a cheap $1.2 bottle of cheap conditioner used specifically for shaving. A big bottle will last for months. I'm only using it for legs and underarms. But I see others have success using for facial hair and shaving their heads as well. Calling something a game changer feels so cliche, but this tip was for me. My razor doesn't get as gunked up. I can see my legs better, so there are less cuts. It's cheaper than the nice shaving cream. But most importantly, I use the olive oil conditioner and my legs are the softest they've ever been. It's insane how much more I enjoy shaving now. Fewer cuts. Thanks to the 10 of you who pointed that out. The conditioner I use is the Garnier olive oil. For my region. It is cheaper than the nice shaving cream I was using, or thereabout even, but the conditioner lasts way longer. I don't shave with just oil because it made the tub too slippery and I'm super clumsy. I am a female, but I do like the thought of being a 300 pounds D-liner with super smooth legs. Anal Ease is good for a toothache. And it's cherry flavored. I work at an adult store. Also, please don't use Anal Ease for anal if you are having painful anal sex. Get some butt plugs and a good lube. Just because you can't feel your sensitive areas being damaged doesn't mean they aren't being damaged. Silicone lube for butt stuffs. Unless using silicone toys, then avoid. Most people have no idea how shitty KY is. It gets sticky. Splurge and buy good lube. If you are in a pinch for fireplace kindling, Doritos or Wheat Thins will work in a pinch. Also the lint from the dryer. Vinegar is amazing. It can be used as a cheap household cleaner. Refresh the coffee maker. And it can cure foot fungus and jock itch. Vinegar also works as a stain remover. For clothes and carpet. And a deodorizer. And is safe for pets to accidentally ingest. It also works as a no-chew spray. I wrap those thick rubber bands, you know the ones that come around broccoli crowns, around tight jar lids to make them grippy and easy to undo. Edit. Row. Muchas gracias for the gold and silver. You all are some fine people. And hopefully less troubled by tight lids from now on. Lots of great tips in the comments too. I always throw on my dishwashing gloves for this. Scuba diver here. Instead of using those expensive defogger gels and sprays on your mask, smear a bunch of dish soap in it. Rinse once or twice. And your mask will never fog during the dive. You can also use this method to keep your windshield from fogging. Smear a bunch of dish soap on a towel. Then rub it all over the inside of your windshield. Take another damp towel and rub the soap off until your windshield is clear. I did this 3 weeks ago and have not had to defog a single time since. Keep a bag of cat litter in the trunk of the car. In case you need extra traction if you get stuck in ice or snow. I see you. Red Foreman. Q-tips to clean your keyboard. Nice tip. If you have a landline telephone, the dial tone is a concert F. By holding the phone to your ear and your finger on the first fret of the first string of your guitar, for example, you can use the dial tone as a reference pitch and accurately tune up without a tuner. It's actually two pitches, F and A. So make sure you don't tune that first fret a major third high and break your string. As a mechanic, a flathead screwdriver is a pry bar, package opener, squarehead, Robertson, screwdriver, hose pick, a punch, test lead, electrical bridge, scraper, chisel, and least importantly, a flathead screwdriver. Robertson, you sick duck. I bet you'd use it on a Torx too. Disgusting. Not so much a product, but dryer lint works great for starting fires. Deodorant antiperspirant can also be used between your thighs and under your boobs. It stops chafing from rubbing and sweat in those areas. Used to do this when working music festivals in insane heat. Had one stick for the pits and one, heavily marked with fluorescent tape, for the downstairs to ward off the scourge we all called gig butt. Bottom shelf cheap vodka. Put it in a spray bottle and squirt it on your bathroom walls to kill mold. Squirt it on clothes to remove any odors. Use it to clean mirrors, glass, windows. Squirt it in your mouth to make cleaning more fun. You can just use drugstore ethanol. It's cheaper and stronger. Kinesiology tape to hold up your boobs when your outfit is too revealing for a normal bra. I used a few strips of tape under my wedding dress, and my girls were good to go the entire day and night. And on that note, do not use duct tape to hold up your boobs ever. It takes skin off. My tits looked fantastic that night, but it was not worth it. Electrical tape in an X shape makes a decent nip cover if you're going braless and don't care about cleavage. Also looks hot in a suicide girl's kinda way. Pickle juice can assist the pH balance in your stomach. This means when out drinking, if your stomach starts to feel queasy, take a shot or two of pickle juice. Why vomit when you're out having fun? On a side and probably more relevant note, pickle juice is essentially the OG Gatorade. If you need to replace electrolytes or simply feel a bit dehydrated, drink some pickle juice and then some water. Even better, drink a pickleback shot. A jeweler's loop can double as a macro lens for your cell phone. Fix the spelling. Good thing I have all these jeweler's loops lying around. Plastic fruit cups are great seedling pots. Eater. Have a toddler. Enough said. What I would do is cut the little divots out of an egg carton. Then when the plant starts, you can just plant the whole thing. Adolf's meat tenderizer is an excellent treatment for bee stings, mosquito bites, Portuguese man-o-war, and no-see-ums. Most venomous bite stings will be less inflamed if you grind in a few wet crystals of Adolf's very soon after. Not fire ants, though. Adolf's meat tenderizer. I'm trying to come up with a joke here, but just can't quite get there. If you have pets, spray a mixture, 2 or 3 to 1, of water to fabric softener on carpet and let it dry before vacuuming. You'll be amazed how much pet hair gets picked up. Bonus. It smells awesome. Head and Shoulders or any dandruff shampoo can usually be used on your face to get rid of fungal acne. Monistat chafing gel is virtually identical to the Smashbox makeup primer and so much cheaper. On a side note, make sure to use silicone primer with silicone-based foundations. and use water-based primers with water-based foundations. If the first ingredient is cone, it's silicone-based. If the first ingredient is water, it's obviously water-based. Ducking, like, and subscribe.